We got Game 1 World Series, Verlander, Nola, the Eagles' undefeated streak on the line. And in this game, believe it or not, my marriage could be on the line. I need Brady's divorce lawyer. Let's go. And we are live. Welcome, everybody, back to another episode of the Money Pod Podcast. This show is going to be a little bit different, so just stick with me. We got a lot to do. So we're talking all sports today. Everything's on the table today. We're talking college. We're talking NFL. We're talking if we got NBA. We're talking B. Diddy with his soccer plays. We are crossing the board today, giving you just winners. That's it. We're not going to go through every game. We're just talking winners all day today. I am your host, your friendly neighborhood capper, Maul's Money. And we got the money team with us, man. We got my guy to my left. If you guys are betting live, you need to listen to this man over here. One of the best in-game live bettors I know. They call him Diddy. What's up, boy?
Go Phillies. That's it. That's all it's about.
Yeah, I like it. I see the
game. We can get game one, then we good.
My hat is a little tight, so I just took it off. And, of course, what's a betting show without an analytics numbers guy and our own personal residential professional gambler, C-Sharp? What's up, man?
What's up, fellas? Obviously, big day for the Phillies. Let's go, Aaron Nola. Also, Robert Quinn, welcome to the nest. We only need you to do one thing, baby. Go get those quarterbacks.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I like it. I like it. All right. And the last person that we got to introduce right now to the money team is you guys. Of course, the fans, the supporters of the show. We wouldn't be where we're going and where we're at today without you guys. So for those who are returning, as always, we appreciate the support. And for those who are new watching the show, hit the damn like button, hit the damn subscribe button, jump on the goddamn money train, because you know what? The train is not stopping. We're going round and round and round, and we will collect 200 while we go past go. We will collect all these properties. We are taking over the goddamn board. This is the Money Pot Podcast betting show. And one more thing. Come bet with your boys. All right. We're going right into the World Series, man. We're talking Phillies. We're talking Nola. We're talking Verlander. I just want to hear sides. There's been so many shows and shit about previews. Let's just give them winners, right? I'm gonna break my bets of what I look at this game and what are the best bets I think for this game. I'm going to do what I have as some of a best bet, a series bet, a long shot MVP, a long shot bet, you know, just to give them a collection of bets to kind of choose from. My best bet is going to be a two-hit parlay. I'm going with the two best, you know, hitters as of right now, Pena and Harper, to get a hit for the game. Just a two-leg parlay. I'll bring that out real quick here. Let me get so this is on FanDuel. We can't do it on DraftKings. DraftKings doesn't allow you to parlay the hits. So I kind of play with FanDuel a little bit more when it comes to my baseball plays. I'll bring that up. I forget what that was off the top of my head. I think it was plus 1010. Might have dropped. Let me bring it up real quick. And then my second best for my series bet. So I've faded Mattress Mac forever, right? That's what I do. I like fading that guy. But the fact that he was putting $10 million on this, I'm not going to hold you. I'm not going to lie. I do have a ticket right now for the Houston Astros to win the World Series. I already have a future ticket. I did it a while ago, months ago. I got it when it was 7-1. So I'm in a good space because I've already hedged the bet, right? I've already hedged the Phillies on the other side, so I'm in a good space. So my series bet is going to be for people who haven't bet. But there's the play real quick, too, as well. two-leg parlay just to get it recorded, hit Pena and Harper. Harper's been the best hitter and best player in baseball, you know, right now. So I don't think he just all of a sudden cools off. I think he still gets on base, still gets a hit. And Pena, he's been clutch. He's been fucking clutch for Houston. And has had some eye-popping performances already in the postseason. So there's my little two-game, two-leg parlay. My series bet. The value is on the Phillies, right? That's my fan talking and my capper hat talking. The value is on the Phillies. I think this line should be a little bit closer than what it is. I think right now, let me bring it up. I think the series bet is – what is the series bet? What is the series bet? I think it was like plus one. Was it plus 175? You guys know off the top of your head?
I got it at 170 at one point.
It was 170?
At one point. I don't know what it is today.
Where is that series bet? I know I've seen it already. Let me go to World Series instead of the game. Here we go.
165.
Yeah, 165. So it's dropping. So it's 165 right now. I think the value is on the Phillies. A lot of people talking about the Phillies, but momentum coming into this, and they do have a lot of momentum. You know, a lot of people are saying, you know, we're getting that underdog wild card feel, even kind of bringing. I know Sharp and I were talking about the those 93 Phillies giving that same feel, but also giving some feel to how the Eagles got to the Super Bowl when they just got hot, and they just kind of ran through everything. But people, it's just quietly, nobody is forgotten that Houston hasn't lost in the postseason. So I don't know how much momentum the Phillies really have facing a team that hasn't lost yet in the postseason. So, but I still think the line should be a little bit closer just because how hot the Phillies have been playing. Every game there's somebody stepping up, and then you have your stars that kind of been steady throughout the whole thing. So I think the line getting plus value on the Phillies. This is a Phillies line here to me. I think Houston, you know, the way they've been playing all year, the way they've been playing in the postseason, this should be more like minus 250, almost minus 300, in my opinion. But I think there's value on the Phillies here. Now, from an MVP standpoint, I think it's really simple for the Phillies. It's going to go through Harper, right? If you know, I would be shocked if the Phillies win and Harper doesn't get the MVP. It's got to be somebody doing something really special. Now, here's a key note for MVPs. The most position has won MVPs has been the pitcher. They've won it 25 times, and they lead all positions in MVPs. So Verlander makes a lot of sense if you're back in Houston. It's a Philly show, though, so I don't know if anybody's really back in Houston. But I'll give you one more. We talked about it already, sticking with these two guys because I think these are the stars of the show. Pena. Rookie to win the MVP. I like his odds at plus 1,800. That's just a shot in the dark. That's all it is. It's all it is, shot in the dark. Just put a little bit of poppy money, poppy store money, that we call it. Put a little 20, you know, 25 maybe. If you're feeling, if you got your bankroll out, put $50 on it, you know, to get a little bit of, just a little bit of fun, a little bit of fun. And then my last bet on the World Series for a long shot bet, and you guys are going to hate it. Going to hate it. I got this game being a sweep. The series being a sweep. Going to hate it. Look at Sharp's face. Hate it. I know. I'm going for the sweep. I'm going for the sweep. This is how I look at it. I think either Houston just – destroys us, or the Phillies make it a series and it goes six or seven. That's how I see the series. I don't, you know what I mean? I don't know if anybody, you know, it's going to be, it's either Houston, we have a problem, or Phillies, they are who we thought they are. It's going to
be two. So would you, and I'm not, this is not something I would do. I'm not really a, just for the record, I'm not a baseball bettor. This has just been a lot of fun. To me, the World Series has kind of been like my little Super Bowl here. I've just been looking at all these random props, just little like half unit bets, just for a little extra side money, because I'll be watching every pitch as a Phillies fan. The Astros to sweep is plus 850 for what it's worth.
Yeah. That I mean, that's either the Phillies make this a series and go six or six or seven games, or I think the Astros sweep us. And that's just me. You know what I mean? That's just me. But, you know, hey. You know, and there's some other plays in here I haven't got a chance to look at. You know, any player to hit two home runs. That looks pretty good. At plus 112. But yeah, that's where I'm at with my plays. But for today's game, game one, I like Pena and Harper to get a hit as a two-way selection. I've been pretty good with those two as well. So I like the plus money on those. Anybody else got any World Series? I know, Sharp, you said you don't really bet baseball much. So
no, but I'll go through mine real quick. I spent majority of the last 24 hours kind of scouring the props. And a couple that I like the most, I'm going to go with the homer pick here. I think if the Phillies win, I think they only win because of one man, and it's going to have to be the same way they won their last World Series, and it's going to have to be because Zach Wheeler pitched on the road in Game 2, lights out, and then pitched on the road Game 6, lights out. Both of his starts are going to be on the road. If he goes lights out and the Phillies win, he'll be the World Series MVP, and that's 20-1. That's just good value for the best pitcher in the series.
it goes with the trend of a pitcher is going to win the MVP, and they've always said in the series is always won on the mound and not by the bats. So
not so fast, my friend.
And my second bet, real quick. And I'll let you go, Diddy. My second bet, I just saw good value in it. Give me Alex Bregman to lead the series in home runs at 18-1.
Yeah, I saw that. What was that?
Total home runs in the series. I think 16 or 18-1. It might have come down, but I got it a little earlier, 18-1. Everyone might be a little different.
Player to hit most home runs. He said Bregman. Yeah, so Bregman on FanDuel is only 10-1. So there's a big difference there. I like Reese. Reese has been fine. Let's go, Diddy. Come on now.
I mean, y'all talking crazy. I guess we're gonna keep it this way. We're gonna go value.
Floor, Diddy. Go ahead.
Let me turn his mic down. Oh, you can back me up. You ain't got to bring me up so close. What I'll say is that I took the value here. I think the Phillies can win this series. I think the value tells me that I need to put money on the value at plus 170. That's where I got it at. It's right now trending at 165. I think that's still good value. Listen, Houston's a tough team. They're probably the best team in baseball right now. They've shown that all year. But I think the Phillies is a hot team. I think the bats are running for them. I think Bryce Harper is doing some phenomenal things in this playoff run. I think the stories around Bryce Harper, this generational athlete that plays baseball since he was 15, the stories around it. So although I think statistically the pitchers have won MVPs, I think they would want, if the Phillies to win, for Bryce to win the MVP, regardless of how Wheeler pitches. Regardless of what Noah does, if Bryce gets a few home runs, which he has five in the playoffs so far. I think he has five home runs.
I think he has four. I think Reese has five. He has four, but he's got a ton of extra base hits too. So I mean, okay. His OPS is outrageous.
Right. I think my goal with that would put money on. So I got money. So here's my money. My money plays are on the value for Phillies to win the World Series. I have Bryce Young also to win the MVP. And then I also just put a backup on that is Yordan Alvarez to win MVP. Because I think if Houston's going to win, it's going to be his bat to get him over. But I don't mind, Justin Verlander there at that money at plus 1,000 if Houston's going to win too. But I'm going to go Phillies. I'm going to go Bryce Harper. My backup is Alvarez, and we'll go that way.
Hey, real quick, I was looking on the wrong line. So Bregman's 13-1, not 10-1 on, I don't know, FanDuel, but DraftKings, Bregman was 13-1. Real Muto's 15-1. I like Bregman 13-1 to lead the series in homers hit.
Okay. I like it. What, real quick, before we move on to the college, do you think it's a mistake to start Nola game one?
Mistake? No.
No? You wouldn't have start Wheeler?
Nah, because, I mean, I think you got to think the better pitcher is Verlander, right?
Yeah.
So I'm not going to put Wheeler in my – I'm going to ultimately put my best pitcher against their best pitcher and for their best pitcher to, you know, beat us in this case. We need a win. So I'll take our best pitcher versus their second best pitcher. Maybe we can split in Houston.
We have to split in Houston.
We don't split.
I'll tell you that right now.
We don't split if Nola is. We possibly don't split if Nola pitches second.
Okay, I get you.
You get what I'm saying? Like, I think we need our best versus their best in Verlander versus Wheeler head to head, and they both have their best games.
Yeah.
Verlander is going to probably win that.
I disagree.
Okay.
So I think the best pitcher now. I'm not talking Justin Verlander in his prime. Justin Verlander in his prime versus Zach Wheeler in his prime, I'll take Justin Verlander. We're not talking that Justin Verlander.
We're not?
No.
He had a lights out year.
Well, here's the thing, guys. So you got to understand how Houston rolls. He pitches, he doesn't eat innings like he used to. He goes up there, he pitches five or six strong, and they hand it to their bullpen. He is not an innings eater. Like Zach Wheeler, I'm telling you right now, Zach, right now, the last 24 months, Zach Wheeler's a better pitcher than Justin Verlander. I'm telling you that right now. He's got better stuff. He just does. That being said, go ahead.
I was going to say, he's just not good in the series, though. And he has a bad record in the World Series. He's not. He hasn't been historically good in the World Series.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I kind of throw that stuff out. But I when I look at pitchers just a baseball fan, I kind of throw numbers out and go with stuff, like command and stuff. And right now, Zach Wheeler's plus in both of those. Verlander's a great player, don't get me wrong, but he this late in his career, he's not going to blow by Schwarber or Hoskins or Harper. He's just not. They're not going to be intimidated by his stuff. And I just think Wheeler has his plus fastball is he's going to be able to get outs to the Astros. That being said, I like Wheeler going game two because Nola's the streakiest pitcher we have. He can be an ace or he can be like a three. He's got great stuff, but his command isn't always there. And so I'll roll the dice with him against Verlander. If we can steal game one, I don't want Aaron Nola. If he didn't pitch game one, he'd have been on like 10 days rest. That to me is a pitcher. That's too much rest. He would lose what he's got, and I wouldn't like that. And kind of like you said, give me Wheeler versus whoever they got coming out number two.
I mean, I would just combat that. Verlander last time he played the Philadelphia Phillies, which is only a couple weeks ago, he had no hits, no runs, and 10 Ks in five innings.
Yeah, great player.
I mean, Harper had off that game too, though. That was a different game.
And like you said, you just said it right there. Five innings. That's what he does. He can give you five elite innings. He cannot go seven. He's not going to go seven innings in this series.
I mean, but to come back, Houston's bullpen is probably one of the strongest in the MLB.
100% agree.
So, I mean,
we're just talking pure pitchers right now. Wheeler's the better pitcher than Verlander.
Where I would go probably a prop tonight. Because I think that's the way Dusty Baker is looking for Justin Verlander, because he wants to probably save him for whatever next game he'll pitch. Is you might want to look at under 17.5 outs for Verlander, because I don't think he goes further than six, just because of the way that series might play out. But I don't know. I mean, you make a good point with Nola being on that long rest. But I'm taking Verlander over Nola for sure. And I think. So I like the strategy. It is what it is at the end of the day. Put the ball down. Our two aces versus their two aces, three aces or two aces.
And my thing on that too is on the back end. So say this is say this doesn't go the way Money Moss is thinking, and say this is a series, and say it does come down to Game Six, must win. I'd rather have Wheeler in Houston than Nola in Houston. I'm just going to leave it at that.
Yeah, you guys are talking about the matchup here. There's a couple props here as well before we switch to college football. Which strikeout? Which pitcher is going to have the most strikeout? Kind of like Nola here, just like you said, because Nola's going to go 6.5, going to 7. He's going to get maybe an inning or two more than Verlander. So I think this is some, kind of plus money here that I kind of like. And then combined pitching is 12.5 strikeouts. Puts them right back at where they are right now. I think Verlander is 6.5 and Nola's 5.5 right now in terms of strikeouts. So that actually puts them right at that number right here. I think Nola's strikeouts are a little bit low at 5.5. On the road, he's been pretty decent, averaging almost 7.
Astros just put the ball, their contact rate's really high for MLB teams. They're not the same, this is kind of a tale of two teams that do it two different ways. Like one team swings in for a lot of strikeouts but hits a lot of homers. The other team puts the ball in play a lot.
All right. So I like the plays. I like everybody's take. We got some best bets out here, and we got some, some futures here that I really like too as well. So, go Phillies as always. I might come off and think differently than most, and that's because I'm following the money and what my head is telling me. Not betting with my heart, but don't ever fucking forget it's always go Phillies, go Philadelphia, everything. So. I hope the Phillies do win.
I can't believe you following Mattress Matt. That's why I can't believe.
Bro, I fade him all the time, but the way the Houston was playing, it only takes one. He's lost, like all his big bets, he's lost. But then he's about to slap the biggest bet ever. And there's another question too that brings it in. What do you think Vegas? Like, do you think Vegas is going to allow this? Like, is the fix in? Because he's going to win $75 million, bro. That's insane.
Well, if he's smart, he hedges. So
yeah, I mean, there's a lot of ways to look at that. If it was looking like the Phillies were going to win, they would offer him a settlement, and he would take it. He'd be too dumb not to.
There's a lot of dumb MFers out here, man.
But when I say settlement, I mean like, hey, you don't want to be looking over your shoulder the rest of your life, settlement.